the last pirate, you guys know I'm a sucker for a good nickname. I actually like Morgan Charrière a little bit more than I think, Kyle, that you do a little bit here. But I'm with you that maybe he shouldn't be a $7 betting favorite against Miranda coming in at plus 450 on the dog side. Kyle, I'll go right back to you for this one. Is this, would you look at this as a play against the last pirate, or do you think that maybe now being back at home, he wants to try to put on a show and get Miranda out of it?
I mean, I'm sure he does. And look, Gabriel Miranda doesn't have a lot to offer, but I'm still going to take Miranda by decision at 12-1. To me, it's just a ridiculous number. Let's just talk about outside of last year at the Civil French thing, he knocked out Manolo Zucchini, right? The Zucchini, who had no business being in a UFC octagon. Body kicks him. We get it. Okay, before that, he fought Diego Silva and Cage Warriors 157, a round three, and they ended on punches. You can't find any footage of that. But let's go back to his previous wins here. Let's go all the way back. Guy named, let's go back to 2017 here and on. We have split decision draw against Marco Kovacovic in 2018. A majority decision over Soren Bach at 12-6. A split decision victory over Lewis Monarch at 12-7 in 2019. Cancel bout. Split decision loss to Jordan Vucenic in 2021. Majority decision win or loss, excuse me, Paul Hughes, 15-8. Are you seeing a theme here? A lot of split decision draws and decisions. Most recently, November 2022, split decision win over Daniel Bazant at 15-9-1. So this guy is barely getting by. Low volume. Never, not one of these fights did he have more than 70 significant strikes landed. So I'm taking a guy who's low volume, who doesn't seem to really have finishing power, against a guy who, you know, has at least subbed out his last guy. He was knocked out in the fight against Benoit, but he made it to the second round against Benoit Saint Denis. If Miranda can just keep the standing and throw a little bit of volume at this guy at 12-1, I'll take a shot out of here. I don't see anything out of Morgan Charrière that makes me think he should be a 7-1 favorite, especially with his volume and his lack of, I mean, we're talking about he's majority drawing guys who are 15-9 on the regional scene, and now I'm supposed to take him at 7-1 on the big show. I don't think so here. I'll take a stab at the underdog here, 12-1 on Miranda.
I'll tell you this. This is very interesting. And I'm looking at that total now at 1.5 to Kyle's rationale here, Matty. And go, man, should I make a play? I know it's $1.65 juice to the over. But if Charrière can't get him out of there, and he's not known for his big punching power early, I wonder if he can get him out late. Do you see it a different way? Do you think that the last pirate is going to show off and show off some real power with his hands?
Yeah, no, I think that's a decent play. So I have him by KO, I think, on my BetUS card. But yep. I'm actually on my full card. I'm going to take round 2-3 here. I think just accumulation, he could get him out of there. Maybe even a late round 2 or early round 3. So I think I took him just by KO here, but
yep.
I don't hate an overplay here whatsoever, especially a guy that went, like Kyle said, the second round to against BSD. So I don't think it's a bad play.
I tend to agree with that rationale that, again, nobody wants to lay $7. We're not in the business of doing that here because upsets happen all the time. So if you want to look at it, I'd look to that over at $1.65. Maddie's going to take it officially for the card here. Charrière to get it done via KO and lay about the same price point that you would with the over. I do like what Kyle's doing, though, that if the last pirate can't get him out here, look at that value at 12-1 for the dog play on Miranda to get it done by the judges. Now, you got to go hope that those French judges, sure, right? You got to hope that they go against the last pirate. But if it gets there, you'd much rather be on where you're sitting, Kyle, than certainly laying at $7 here in the last pirate.
100%. And look, I don't think Gabriel Miranda's great. Again, this is a principle thing for me. Again, I just don't think Morgan Charrière has done enough for me to say, okay, this guy is a 7-1 favorite. And I don't think Gabriel Miranda's bad enough. A second round loss to Benoit Saint-Denis ages pretty damn well. Yeah. And, you know, we'll talk about that last fight with Poirier and stuff, but it ages pretty damn well. He's one of the baddest dudes in the division here. So, look, you get it. If you got a 3-round fight here and neither guy's landed 100 significant strikes and you don't really have any takedowns, 12-1, which bag would you rather be holding at the end of the fight?
Totally agree. And so interesting ways to attack that there for Matty. Going to go with the KO prop. Kyle's going to look to Miranda with the upset at 12-1. Again, like, subscribe, betustv.com/join if you haven't done so already. Of course, you can always hit us up on X. at BetUS TV. You can always go at Matty Betts, at DFS Bachelor, at D Ross Sports. So all the ways you want to try to get at us before this show is over. And yes, Matty Betts is live right now in Paris. Matty, where is your, like, if you're in France, did you think about buying what are those hats they wear over there? The berets? Did you think about getting a beret?
I don't have a clue, bro. I don't know shit about this place. I've done nothing right. I'm in like shorts and a polo day one. I'm the only person in France that was wearing shorts. I didn't bring the right adapter to plug in my cell phone to the hotel room. Mm. I have no idea what I'm doing here, bro. Here's what I'm doing here. I'm betting the mortgage on Money Moicano to win the fight, and then I'm leaving. No, I'm actually staying a few more days. I'm here till Wednesday.
Oh,
so
God.
A few of my buddies are here. We're going to go sightseeing. I told them after the fight's end, we're going sightseeing. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then I'm leaving. But I don't know what I'm doing here.
Well, okay, I got a lot of questions because I've never been to France. I do want to go, like, Normandy's over there. I want to see the Bluff, and for historical purposes, I'm sure you're going to see the Eiffel Tower when you're over there. Why is nobody wearing shorts? What's the weather like? Is it 40 degrees or something?
Shit. Yeah, it's windy and rainy, bro. It's windy and rainy. Yeah.
Welcome to France.
It's like, yeah, what do you think? Like 50
you're not
degrees?
Getting engaged or anything, right? Like, it's a lot of people 50, go to France just to propose. You're not proposing to anyone, right? That's a French. Oh, you go over there and propose.
I don't plan on it, but if my quarter million parlay wins and I'm out at some, you know, you never know what's gonna happen. But no, in all seriousness, it's like 50 degrees here. I live in Boca Raton, South Florida. The hotel rooms are like a dorm room. You can't even move. I'm 5'11", 230, bro. I can barely fit in the shower. I don't know, man. I know I sound like a spoiled South Florida American, but
This is so beautiful. This is why every
American... It's a cool atmosphere, and you, like, walk around, and, like, it is cool, but, like, the hotels are just... I can't... It's tough.
I love this, because, Kyle, you know me. This is why every American needs to go abroad and stop bitching about how great we have it here in this good old US of A.
100%. And, you know, I want all the politicians and shit to watch us too, because, you know, we don't just get it from the people. Now it's just everywhere you turn on, like, America's so bad, and they're eating all the cats. And it's like, okay, knock it the hell off, all right? It's not that, like, I'm going to leave today. I might golf. I might go to a bar. I'm going to have a great day. Almost everyone I meet's going to be cool.
There you go.
I'm not going to be cramped in a weird French with a stupid power converter that they have in France. See what I mean? Like, let's just knock it off.